Hi, this is Uma Mahesh from CRM Months. In this video, I'm going to explain how to display the successful message with the reference number when record is submitted through CRM portals. So in the most of the scenarios, we have the unique number for the support ticket, like a case, or it may be the opportunity, or it may be lead. We will have some auto-generated numbers we will be implemented based upon our scenario. So when you create a case from the portal, so if you want to show the user, hey, your case has been created, this is your reference number. So that kind of a successful messages if you want to display. So that by default with the out of box, with the entity forms or web forms, it is not possible. So there we have to write some custom code. That's what I'm going to explain it here. So one of the most common requirement in the portals, whenever you submit the request or case is submitted through the portals, we must give the success message to the user with the case number or some reference number. So the above requirement is not possible with the out of box entity form or web form to display the success message with the reference number. Hence, we must develop the custom liquid code. So how we can develop that, we can see it here. So the step one, so we need to create a web template and we need to paste the following code. So like here, we are the first line, what we are doing, we have declared the variable called case in the liquid code, and we are retrieving the incident here, entities.incident. So in my scenario, I've taken a case entity. So I'm taking that. So here in this line, so we assign a case variable and entities.incident in like this in the liquid template, we can do the query of the entities. So I'm doing the query to the case entity incident. And here request is nothing but in the URL, if you have the parameter, the query string parameter, there I am passing the ID, that current record ID. So if you pass that current record UID, so you will get the currently which is the record is submitted, that record ID, you will get it here. So if that case, I'm checking the null condition, if that object is not equal to null, then I am saying successfully submitted. Here that case dot ticket number, I'm taking that reference number. So the case entity out of box case number field is a ticket number. That schema name I'm printing here, and I'm doing the end if. This simple line of code you can copy paste in the web template. You can create and you can paste it. So you can see here I have created a web template and I have given this is a name, and here we have taken this is the same code, we have placed it here. And in the next step, we need to create a paste template. So I have created a paste template, and the type I have selected as a web template, and which is we have created, I have selected here. And the next step, we need to create a web page. In that web page, we have selected this, we can create a web page. In that, we have selected a parent page, and success message is the case successful message is a partial URL, and we have selected that paste template which is we created above. And then wherever, like a which entity form you want to show that successful message when it is submitted, so we can go to that entity form. So in my case, I have the one entity form I have taken. So that in that entity form we have a redirect. There is a section called redirect. In that section, we can select it successful message type. It is a display the message or redirect. Two options will be there. So once you select as a redirect, so here I can select which web page you want to show. In the above, I created that web page, I can select it. And here I want to select this append record ID to the append the record ID to the query string. And this parameter name, I have given a small ID. So this whatever the name you are given, that query string ID, in our code, in the request.parameters.id, I have given, right? That same thing you have to give it here. So like this, we can display our success message whenever you create a record, or when you update a record with this, some reference number, we can give it to the users. Thank you so much for watching this video.